time to review the new Wolfgang Gartner album, 10 Ways to Steal Home Plate. Wolfgang Gartner is an electronic artist who has pretty much been putting out some good singles every now and then. Comes back with some electro-house tracks. That's pretty much all I have to say as part of this introduction. It seems that Wolfgang Gartner completely rushed this album. It seems like this album was just splattered together in the matter of maybe like, what, a week or several weeks? It's 30 minutes long. That's a pretty short length for an album. And if you're gonna make an album 30 minutes long, you have to at least pack a lot of stuff into those 30 minutes for such a short runtime. And this album doesn't do that at all. In fact, along with the short time length, a huge problem is that a lot of these tracks just feel very undercooked and underdeveloped. They just feel like they were absolutely rushed and they were just put on the album without actually realizing, hang on, this track sounds like crap. There's no flow to how these tracks piece together. It sounds like they're just put in a random order. You could put them on shuffle and it still wouldn't make a difference. The opening track, Turn Up, is a horribly annoying track featuring Wiley and Trina, both of which are just repeating the same tedious vocal snippet over and over and over and over and over and over and over again. And then you've got this instrumental that sounds like a police siren just wailing in the background. And whilst you have tracks like those that are very annoying, you've also got other tracks that are very boring, just flat out generic dance club crowd moving tracks that maybe if I heard them in a dance club and everyone was totally getting hype and getting down to the drop of a track, then yeah, maybe they'd be alright. When you're listening to it on your own, it's a very underwhelmingly bland track at best. Like maybe the track Feel Right, which is quite a generic club mover. I would say the exact same things with tracks like Saved and Replay It, which bring no personality or no genuine interesting content. Look, I'm relatively new to Wolfgang Gartner's stuff, but I did give a listen to his previous work, his previous album, and his stuff there was a lot more dynamic, was a lot more exciting, and at least it sounded interesting. And most of all, it sounded like it was actually developing over the course of its runtime. Take a track on this album like Looking For You, which could have been a really nice trance track, but is criminally short. If this song was a steak, it'd still be bleeding fresh from the cow. The final track Up In Smoke, another very disappointingly and underwhelmingly uneventful track. It's pretty much all build up, and the only climax or drop is towards the very beginning. So what happens for the rest of the track then? Basically nothing. May as well just be replaced with pure silence, because nothing actually ever comes out of the rest of the track. I guess the saving grace is for this album, 10 Ways to Steal Home Plate, are the tracks Hurricane Slurricane, very retro, disco-inspired track, very nice, funky bassline, very entertaining with E40's hilarious verse. Maybe I'd give credit to the track Unholy, which has these nice raving synths, kind of a chirpy production with the pianos on the build-up, as well as Bobby Saint's very soulful, deep vocals that kind of cut through it all. And I do think it's kind of mixed nicely. The track Y.W.M.O. is pretty much the same as Unholy, but I mean, it is kind of alright. I do think it's kind of good, relative to the rest of the album, which is just pure blandness. 10 Ways to Steal Home Plate isn't quite there. It's just an album that is completely undercooked, lacking any sort of interesting dynamic or production that will leave it feeling memorable. Again, at 30 minutes in runtime, and just most of the tracks feeling like they were just put together in a matter of days and then just slapped onto the album in a random order, just not there. I'll probably be giving this album a 4 out of 10.